49. Great-grandma was in her prime. She packed up the things and the kids right glad and headed for the west with great-granddad. They joined up with a wagon train and prodded that ox team across the plain. Nothing to see but sage and sand, not one hitchhiker nor a hot dog stand. One fine day they heard a meadowlark. Great-granddad says, here's where we park. Grandma says, well, I'm game. Unloaded the kids and they staked out a claim. Great-granddad built a house of sod by a hustle and a tussle and the grace of God. And just as he was finishing the roof, a cyclone came and the house went poof. They had a team of buckskin mules. Great-grandma tried to drive the fools. Well, they ran away with a load of kraut, upset the buckboard and threw her out. Great-grandma, when the west was new, wore hoop skirt and a bustle too. But when the engines came and things looked bad, she fit right alongside a great-granddad. She worked hard 7 days in the week to keep granddad well fed and sleek. She biled the beans and she hung out the wash, and she never had time to drink tea, by gosh. She could ride herd and plow and shoot, bought great-granddad and the kids to boot. And kids they had in just a few years, there was 21 boys as wild as deer. One boy's a raising the cane, chasing each other across the plain. Great-grandma was proud, no doubt, but she had to work like all get out. Next she had to scrub, wash 21 shirts in the old wash tub, cook 21 meals 3 times a day. That's how she frittered her time away. She worked all day and she slept all night, and it seems to me that's just about right. But her great-granddaughter's just the other way. She's up all night and she sleeps all day.